Hi everyone, Claudia here. I hope you're doing well. In today's video, I want to show you 10 Microsoft Word tips that you need to know if you're not already familiar with them. Microsoft Word has come a long way from being a program just used to type documents. There are some really cool things that you can do with the newer versions of Microsoft Word, so that's what I want to show you today. As always, I will leave a list of topics I'll be covering in today's video in the description box, along with their timestamps if you are looking for something specific. If you like this video while you're watching it, please give it a thumbs up. It really does help out my channel. And let's get started. The first thing I want to talk about is removing an image background. So to insert an image, you'll go up to the Insert tab, Pictures, and to insert something from your computer, you would do Picture from File. There's Stock Images and Online Pictures. We're gonna do a stock image. So let's say, for example, we want this picture of a cactus. We're going to click on it, insert the image, and as you can see, we have it right here. So maybe we want this cactus, but we don't want the pink background on it. We can actually remove the background within Microsoft Word. So if you click on the image, you can see that it is now outlined, and up here, picture format popped up. So we're gonna click on picture format. And the first option here is remove background. So we're gonna click remove background, and it's gonna automatically kind of detect the background. And as you can see, it did a pretty good job. Anything in purple is gonna be deleted, and anything not in purple is going to stay in the image. But it did cut off our cactus a little bit at the bottom. So we're actually gonna mark areas to keep. So if we click this and kind of just draw over the bottom part of the cactus, and let go, it's gonna add the rest of the cactus to the image. Similarly, if you did want to remove areas that the background detected, you can go to remove areas, and maybe you wanna remove this back cactus leaf. You can do that. It just takes a little bit more finessing to mark areas to remove. So now we're gonna click keep changes, and as you can see, we have a lovely cactus without a background. The second tip I want to talk about is saving an image as its own file. So maybe you want to use this cactus image for something else and you want to save it, but if you just click save, it's going to save the entire document. So the way you can save it as its own file is to click on it, right click, and click save as picture. You'll want to save it as, you know, a JPEG or a PNG or PDF or something like that. I always just default to saving it as a JPEG or a PNG if you want it to have a transparent background. So since I want this to have a transparent background, we'll do PNG and we'll name it cactus and save it. And now if I go to open up the cactus right here from my downloads, you can see that it is just the cactus without a background. And it's also now its own separate image, so we can use this for anything else. You may also notice if you try to move your image around, it's not gonna go anywhere. So my third tip is showing you how to move images around. So if you click on the image, again, picture format's gonna pop up. In the wrap text option, if you click this drop down, the default is in line with text, and we wanna change it to square. So now we can move our image around and put it anywhere we want in the document. Also, if you do need to crop your image, if you just go to picture format and click the crop tool, you can crop it however you like. And once you're happy with it, you just click enter. The fourth thing I want to show you how to do is text dictation. This is so cool. So if you're trying to take notes or write something down really quickly, you can actually just speak to Microsoft Word and it will type out your words for you. So if we want to do that, make sure you're on the home tab right here, and as you'll see right here, there's a dictate option. So we're gonna click dictate, and it's automatically gonna just start listening, as you can see here, and it's gonna start writing down everything that I'm saying. If you want it to stop listening, just click the blue microphone right here. And as you can see, it'll say to tap the microphone to resume if you wanna keep typing. But here's just an example of what it looks like when Microsoft Word hears your voice and types out your words. You can also change the settings to profanity filter, automatic punctuation, and even change the language, which is really cool. My next tip is sort of the opposite, and this is read aloud. So this is a feature on Microsoft Word where, you know, maybe you have a full document and instead of reading it, you want to listen to it. Maybe you're multitasking or maybe reading's just really difficult for you. You can actually choose to have Microsoft Word read the document out loud to you. So the way you do that is by going to review and read aloud. And once I click read aloud, it's gonna start reading the words on this page right here.
Thank you for watching today's video on some amazing features Microsoft Word has to offer.
It is kind of a robotic voice, but you can actually choose to change the voice. There are a couple different options in this little settings area right here. You can change the reading speed, and there are a couple different voice options to choose from. My next tip is find and replace. So I want to talk about how to quickly find things in your documents as well as replace them if need be. So for example, maybe you have a document like one right here, and you're just going to be copying and pasting the same information to a lot of different people, and you just want to find the name and be able to quickly replace it in your document. So if you want to quickly find something, all you have to do is Command F, and that's going to find. And so we can just type Barb, and anywhere in my document that says Barb is going to be highlighted, and we can just scroll through and find all the instances where my document says Barb. Now, if we want to replace it, so maybe we're sending the same information to Samantha. So what we can do is actually go to Edit, Find, and Replace, and this is going to pop up right here. So we want to find Barb, but we want to replace it with Samantha. So now if I click Replace All, as you can see, Microsoft Word made 4 replacements. Anywhere that used to say Barb is now going to say Samantha. My next tip is editing a PDF within Microsoft Word. This one's really exciting because, as you can see here, I opened up a PDF, and what I could do is highlight all of the text in here, but it might be kind of messed up if I tried to paste it into Microsoft Word. And if you don't have Adobe, then you might not have another way to edit PDFs. So what you can actually do is go to Microsoft Word, and we are gonna go to File, Open, and I am going to open my farmer's market document, which is a PDF. And as you can see, it's now converting the PDF to a Word document. Now everything's in here, and I can edit these dates, these times, whatever I want to edit super easily. So my second example is if your PDF doesn't have text that you can highlight and easily copy and paste into a Word document. For example, this one right here, I can't copy and paste any of these words. It's just being formatted as a picture, and that's not what we want. So what I can do is, again, open this PDF document within Word, and it's going to extract the words from the document into a Microsoft Word document. And the reason I used this one as an example is because the formatting might not be perfect. In some instances it might be, in some it might not be, but this way you can have all the text that you want to copy and paste into a separate document if that's what you're using it for, instead of having to just open an image and manually type out all the words that you wanted to copy and paste. The next tip I want to talk about is Format Painter, which can be really great if, for example, here you have text that you've specifically formatted with a custom color, a gradient, a size, italics, whatever you want. If you want to quickly copy and paste the format from this to this, there is a way to do that. If you put your cursor onto the formatted text that you want to copy and go up here to this little paintbrush, as you can see, it says copy formatting from one location and apply it to another. We're gonna click on that. And now if we go back here, we have a cursor with a little paintbrush next to it. So if I highlight text that I want to reformat and just let go, it's gonna automatically format it identically to the one that we copied. The text isn't going to change, just the formatting, which is really, really helpful. So let's say you want to do the opposite. My next tip is clearing formatting. So let's say you copied something from another document, you're putting it in the one you're working on now, but it was formatted with maybe a document color, a font color, sizing that you don't need and you don't want to have to go through and retype everything. What you can do, if it's already pasted into the document, you can highlight the text that you want to clear the formatting for and just go up here and click clear all formatting, and it's just going to go back to the default for the document that you're working on. So for here, it went to this font and this font size. If you haven't yet pasted what you copied, what you can actually do before you hit paste is go to this drop down right here, which is paste special, and click keep text only. And it's going to just paste without any of the formatting that you had from another document. Finally, I want to show you how to quickly add lines to break up your document if you need to. So say I want to add a line right here between these two lines of text. There are a bunch of different line options you can use. So if you just click the three dashes and hit enter, it's going to automatically make a single line. If you do three equals and click enter, you will get a double line. If you do three asterisks, you'll get a dotted line. And finally, if you do three tildes, you'll get a wavy line. So that is it for today's video. I hope you found these Microsoft Word tips helpful, and hopefully you can use these in the future. If you liked this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. I really appreciate the support, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.